Welcome to another episode of The Verse, the Word, and the Hymn. Today, the verse I've chosen is from the Gospel according to St. Matthew, chapter 16, verse 18. And I tell you, you are Peter, on this rock I will build my church, and the gates of hell shall not prevail against it. And the hymn I've chosen today is The Church's One Foundation. This is a Christian hymn written in the 1860s by Samuel John Stone. The hymn describes the church's relationship to its foundation, being Jesus Christ. It is represented as the collective Christian fellowship of the earth as it is wholly united by its Savior, the Son of God. The hymn was composed as a primary answer to the division within the Church of South Africa generated by John William Colenso, first Bishop of Natal, who denounced much of the Bible as untrue. The issue was referenced to within the fourth verse of the lyrics, though with a scornful wonder men see her so oppressed, and by schisms rent asunder, by heresies distress. When Bishop Colenso was dismissed for his teachings, he pleaded to the higher religious authorities in England. It was then that Samuel Stone became included in the discussion, and it sparked him to draft a set of hymns based on the Apostles' Creed in 1866. He titled it 12 Hymns on the 12 Articles of the Apostles' Creed. The Church's One Foundation is based on the 9th article, the Holy Catholic Church and the Communion of Saints. The first stanza goes like this. The Church's one foundation is Jesus Christ, her Lord. She is his new creation by water and the Word. From heaven he came and sought her to be his holy bride. With his own blood he bought her, and for her life he died. It goes like this. The usual apologies for any mistakes in rendering the hymn. I'll be singing this. Okay, it goes like this. The church's one foundation is Jesus Christ, her Lord. She is his new creation, the water and the world. From heaven he came and sought her to be his holy bride. With his own blood he bought her, and for her life he died. Elect from every nation, at one o'er all the earth, her charter of salvation, one Lord, one faith, one birth. One holy name she blesses, partakes one holy food, and to one home she presses with every grace endued. Though with a scornful wonder men see her sore oppressed, by schisms rent asunder, by heresies distress, it seems their watch are keeping, their cry goes up half long, and soon the night of weeping shall be the morn of song. The church shall never perish, her dear Lord to defend. To guide, sustain, and cherish is with her to the end. Though there be those that hate her and false sons in her pale, against the foe or traitor, she ever shall prevail. Mid toil and tribulation and tumult of her war, she waits the consummation of peace forevermore, till with the vision glorious, her longing eyes Saints are blessed, and the great church victorious shall be the church at rest. And she on earth has union with God, the three in one, and mystic sweet communion with those whose rest is won. O happy ones and holy, Lord, give us grace that we, like them the meek and lowly, on high may dwell with thee.